What's going on, everyone? Today I want to discuss about a really common mistake that React beginners always make with useState. Right here I have a very simple counter app which just increment on click. As you can see here on the right, it increments by one every time I click on the button. And if you look at the code, it's quite simple. We just have useState with set count and the count. And on the on-click handler, we just increment the count by one. Right, so this all works fine in theory, but what if I have multiple set counts with count plus one as an argument? Things gonna look a little bit different. You see that? It's supposed to increment the count by three every time I click on a button, but now it only increment by one. Well, the reason behind this is because when you click on the buttons, the on-click handler actually batch all of these three set counts together and then flash the updates to the DOM, and then the DOM only re-render once. So this is just for the performance benefits. So if you could look at the set count in the on-click handler increment, if you look at this, the count variable at the start is 0 and is plus 1 is equal 1, right? But however, the count on line 9 and 10 also 0 at the time as well. So this also gonna be 0 plus 1 equal 1. Same for line 10. So when these three set counts batch together, all three ones are actually overridden each other. And that's why if you click on the button now, if you click on button, it only results into one display on the screen. So how we can fix this? So the way we fix this actually very simple. All you have to do is you have to use the function callback in a set state in React. So the set count is gonna take a function with a current state. I just name it current count in this example. So this callback function does is that it take a current state and then increment that current state by one. And if you look at some example in React docs, they actually put this previous count or previous state, but that's just kind of simple naming so that you can understand things better. But actually the value in this argument in this callback function, actually the value of the current state. So if you refresh this and if you increment, now you increment correctly. So this is the way that you avoid count number not display correctly or not increment correctly. So this problem only happen when you have a state that needs to be updated based on the previous state. A second common mistake that React beginner make as well is not knowing the set state in React is actually async. So if you look at another simple example here, it's really similar to the last example. However, now I have a display message for the count number. So in the code, I have a useState for the message, and in the increment click handler, I'm also displaying the count as well. Basically, I just set the message with the count number and gonna display the message next to the count number. So if I click on this increment, as you can see, the count display message doesn't display the correct number of the click that I click on the increment button. So you might have wondering why, but actually, like I mentioned before, the set state is asynchronous, is not synchronous. So if you look at the increment click handler, if you look at the set count, this is gonna increment the count by one. However, the count right here is actually zero at the time. And why this set count being processed? The count here is being the count here is being captured at 0. And when React batch all of them together, the count at 0 is captured, and that's why when it flushes the update to the virtual DOM, the message appears to be 1 unit lag behind. Now, this problem arises when we have a state X that depends on state Y. So one of the simple way to fix this is to use reducer, which I'm not covering in this video. I'm gonna dedicate a new video to use reducer, and probably the simplest solution to fix these issues in this counter app is to create a intermediate variable that share between state count state and message state. So we're gonna create a new variable, new count equal count plus 1, and then I can set new count in set count and set message, and this is gonna work correctly, as you can see here, because now new count is shared. So this can prevent the async nature or batch update of the React set state. Alright, I think these are the two common mistakes that React beginners always make. I've seen it a lot when I mentor intern and grad. So if you like the video, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. If you have any other idea, please leave a comment below. Cheers, guys.